Hello YouTube, here's Jimac with another Battlefield video. I didn't think I'll have anything interesting until, I don't know, Battlefield 4 ships. But it turns out we had quite a nice test ground for my TP missile skills. In the previous games, well, we started and we played against some Czechs who were, well, cluddy, really. Was good in the jets, so we couldn't do the things that we're gonna be demoing in this video. And then the two maps that don't have jets came out. The what's it called, the Riverside and this whatever railroad Kaiser. I don't really know the names of the maps yet. I only played them for 20 hours. Anyway, so what we're doing is we have a long-distance anti-chopper loadout. So I'm gunning for Giuseppe, who's very cautious, always going back to our base, which is also guarded by the... well, the rest of the blueberries actually go and storm the enemy base with everything that we have. I mean, it is good to have more people attacking than defending, but usually the armor and the jeep are better fitting their defense role. But in any case, I had the opportunity to test the TV missile. I'm still terrible compared to the footage that you can find on the net, especially you know, Level Cap and Matimio. If you don't follow these two guys, even though they're on PC, and even if you play on the console, go and subscribe to their channels. They have fantastic chopper footage, and Matimio is really great with the TV missile. Like, he, the number of times I fail, I mean, the number of times he fails, that's usually what I do in a match. He just scores every single shot, and I've only learned a few basics with the TV missile. It is very much like the AT4, so you have to aim at where you think the chopper will be rather than aiming at the chopper and compensating, because there is considerable lag. And also, you don't want to go all the way on the sticks. The only two cases where you can do that is when you're flying with a blueberry. This was a very lucky tail hit. I hit the little pole, not the pole, the horizontal pole, when trying to hit the LAV in their base like two times. Anyway, I digress as always. So don't pull the sticks, you know, all the way. The only two cases is when you're flying with a blueberry pilot, and he just never gives you a good shot. So that's when you need to like go all the way when you exit the chopper, you know, riding the TV missile. Always. You know, have the thought of the final scene of Dr. Strangelove. So that's the only case. And the other one is when you're really at the end of your trajectory and you're just trying to save a wrong, like in here, I went all the way to the right and it's usually too late. Anyway. So when you're just steering, just be gentle, you know, go, you know, to a quarter of the shift of the stick. It's just slight corrections of where you think the chopper will be. And you can tell that this guy figured out what's happening. And I don't think I've... Well, I did hit the transport chopper when it was dodging me, or when it wasn't just hovering in the air in a duel, but you know, I can only hit stationary or almost stationary objects. Half the time. But, you know, for long distance, and this is also a part where we completely mess up, because I thought, you know, Sherman and Sonjicek, because I said that I got the carrier near our base, and I thought they're capping it. So Giuseppe told me to grab the flag. I grabbed the flag, and I thought they're working on the cap, and I got off the chopper now, wanting to score it as soon as they cap it, and then nobody's actually capping the flag. So this is a horrible moment. I think like a full squad of the opposing team left around this time, so that's perhaps why we were able to score. And also like the attack chopper went onto me, and for some reason he hit a tree. You're gonna see it in a moment. And then I won that gunfight, you know, barely. I was trying to get back into the chopper, but you know, the flag fight included some Igla people, or Stinger actually. We're flying. No, Igla. They're the Russians. That's about it. Also, you can see me using as a gunner using the zoom optics, which is not that good for infantry. Well, sometimes it is, like on CTF actually, people tend to hang around the flags, and so that's good for like being in very far distance away from the Jeep and the Stingers, and pick them off with the zoom optics. It is great for the choppers though. So many times, like at the beginning of this game, you saw me take out the gunner. For these long distance fights, it is the best perk to have. And I'm still carrying the flag. For some reason, they didn't seem to push forward much. But like I said, they didn't play as a full team for good half of the game. But I'm still showing you that because I got some TV missile kills. So that's it. That's all I know about the TV missile. Also a good thing. I hit the hit the thing again. TV missile is also good for taking like the last second takeout of stationary vehicles or ground vehicles when the pilot is actually attacking them. So you don't have any chance of steering the missile for short distances, so you just have to kind of time it right and just shoot it straight. Also be careful about, you know, the circle canceling the flight so you can go back to the chopper. But you know, numerous times I've exited the when the missile hit something, I've exited the chopper accidentally. So but we did score this one for some reason after winning that that chopper fight. But enjoy the game. Sherman gets his two sweet tank kills, choppers. So you're gonna be able to see that from the bird's eye view. I hope you guys enjoy this as much as we did enjoy killing these dudes. And hopefully I'll have some more footage involving the TV missile. Take care. Bye-bye.